All right, Casey Oxendon with MMA Inside the Cage. I'm right here with one of the greatest jiu-jitsu legends of all time, Mario Sperry. You know, you were in the golden era, man. One of the reasons that I even got into MMA was seeing those articles back in the day in Black Belt magazine, you know, how to be an MMA fighter, and it was called Noel's Bard back then, and all those videos. And then you sort of disappeared for a little while. Of course, you were one of the greatest on the mats there in Brazil. And you sort of disappeared to the American public a little bit, but now you're back in a big way there with the Blackzilians. You're here with Rashad at UFC 145. Talk about that just a little bit.
Yeah, well, first of all, thank you for the opportunity to be here giving you this interview. Yeah, you're right. Back in 2007, I realized that I couldn't fight anymore. I was getting too old for the business, and I decided to try new ventures. So I started my own business back in Brazil. And I was still training, helping Nogueira brothers, training a little bit with Anderson Silva, Junior dos Santos, and all the other guys. Last year I came to Florida and I trained with the Blackzilians. I was with my family in Disneyland, and I had a good time with them there. So, and Glenn Robinson invited me to join the team to help Rashad. So I'm here. For this new opportunity, you know, to train a great fighter in a great show.
Nice. So talk a little bit about that, about your training. What sort of things have you implemented into Rashad's game? I mean, you're definitely an outstanding mentor coming from a very traditional Brazilian jiu-jitsu area. But, man, you did do mixed martial arts. You were involved in no-holds-barred fighting, you know, years ago before anybody was really involved. How do you feel like that's implemented into Rashad's training for this fight?
Well, to work with Rashad is pretty easy. He's a great athlete. Tremendous athlete. He's very strong, fast. He's got an excellent background, wrestling background. He knows jiu-jitsu. I think my work is more than not just technical, but also to build up a strategy for this fight, and that's what we've been doing. You know, I didn't work with him too much, just 1 month and a half, around 50 days. So the time I had was just more to build up my strategy for this fight, looking for, you know, what he does best and increase the quality of his game.
So what do you think it's going to be? You know, of course, Rashad has the big right hand, but he's also known for grinding away at his opponents. I mean, he can go five rounds and do, you know, work all night long. What do you think it's going to be? Do you think it's going to be a new strategy altogether, or do you think it's going to be business as usual, an early night or all night long?
That's a hard question. We're talking about MMA, and when we talk about MMA, anything can happen. It's unpredictable. That's the beauty of the sport. For us, would be good a fight that lasts a little bit longer. That's the only thing that we didn't see in John Jones. And we have a five round fight, and I believe if this fight goes longer, it's better for Rashad.
Nice. Now let's switch gears a little bit to the Brazilian jiu-jitsu world, and it actually where it crosses over with mixed martial arts. Currently, there's a big super fight matchup that is scheduled between Braulio Stima and Nick Diaz. And of course, Braulio, he's a legend in the sport. Helped in the development of Brazilian jiu-jitsu in Europe and in England. And then, of course, Nick Diaz. He needs no introduction. He's also a black belt, but he's not known as a tournament jiu-jitsu guy. Talk a little bit about this matchup. How you think it's going to go, and you know, what are the strengths and weaknesses of each guy?
Well, both of them are great jiu-jitsu fighters, but one is more specialized in the jiu-jitsu competitions as itself, as Braulio, and another, Nick Diaz, that's specialized in MMA. We're talking about the jiu-jitsu fight, so I think Braulio has more chances to win this fight, but you know, they're great both fighters, so we can expect everything. But if you had to bet, I would put my money on Braulio because he's more involved with this kind of competition.
Nice. Now, back there with the Blackzilians, of course, you said you worked with Rashad a lot for this fight or you know, for the last at least 45 days. Are there any other guys that have fights coming up that you you know, have really taken a special liking to that we're going to see you know, maybe a little touch of the Mario Sperry on in upcoming bouts?
Well, actually, in the Blackzilians, man, it's been a while that I don't see so many fighters with such quality together. I helped, you know, Eddie Alverez yesterday. He did all right. We were very lucky with his perform. I mean, we're very glad with his perform. And pretty much, you know, I kind of learning more than teaching those guys. They're such a great fighters. So as I told you before, I'm more into to create a strategy of the fight for those guys, more into getting in their minds and understand what they think, understand their qualities and their weakness, and try to use what they know to help them in the fight. So I think we should open our eyes with Guto, you know, Sente, that's going to be fighting in Strike Force, and Jay-Z is coming back strong as well, and this new kid coming, Yuri Villefort. He's just 20 years old, 21 years old, and you watch those three guys. They're gonna come up very strong next month, and of course Anthony Johnson he had not a pretty, you know, not a performance that represents his name against Vitor Belfort. He's a great athlete, and I think now he's more composed. He more focused. And I think he's gonna come back to the top again.
Now, talk a little bit more about Eddie Alverez. You know, he came back from that loss over Shinya Aoki. He was in a spot, though. You know, he was coming off of a loss period in his previous fight, but then his loss before that had come to Shinya Aoki. He stops Aoki in round one. He looks fantastic. You know, talk a little bit about Eddie Alverez and really what he did to change his game, to revamp, and to really come on strong for this fight.
Once again, another great athlete, easy to work with, tremendously focused. You know, he came to me, Mario, I have to fight Aoki, you know, and help me with my jiu-jitsu. Listen, man, I won't help you with your jiu-jitsu. You cannot fight jiu-jitsu against Aoki. What you have to do is to avoid jiu-jitsu. It's the opposite. So let's do it. Let's try to do a strategy to avoid jiu-jitsu. You won't learn. Even me, in my golden days, I wouldn't fight him in the ground. I wouldn't risk. Why I would risk? I would, you know, I would bring him to the environment that he's not used to. Let's keep this fight standing. Let's put him against the cage and try to punish him there. And that's what we did.
So, well, that's phenomenal, and that, what a phenomenal list, man. If you could, you know, of course, get Eddie Alverez that big win last night and then roll back in here and pick that one up with Rashad, what that wouldn't be a huge feather in your cap. So in the future, what do we have to look forward to with Mario Sperry? Are you going to stick around? Are you going to keep doing this? Are you going to keep bringing these champions to the forefront and open a whole new era for Zay Mario Sperry?
You know, life's short. You have to live as good as you can, and everyone is looking the same thing, man, looking for the same thing, happiness. And I'm pretty happy today. In just one weekend, I was involved in two great shows. One was Bellator, and today is UFC. So what can I say? I'm pretty happy, and you can bet I'll be around for a while, and I think we're gonna have more interviews in the near future.
Yes, sir. Well, it's certainly been an honor to be here with you. It's been Casey Oxendine and the one and only Mario Sperry with MMA Inside the Cage. Thank you so much. What an honor. What an honor.